Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome to the Dutch RC channel for something quite different. And in case you are not familiar with my channel is mostly about remote control toys. And even though this is a remote controllable, this brick-based toy, yeah, it's more a brick-based toy, right? With power functions, as you can see, it comes with two motors, controller and stuff. But yeah, it's something completely different. In the past, I have featured an RC robot that was brick-based. So yeah, it's a bit in line with that. But we're gonna see what we have here. I came across this one at Banggood. So it's from China, even though it is Lego compatible. It's obviously not from Lego itself. And therefore the price is significantly lower as well. There is a link in the description of this video. Check it out to see the current pricing and availability. As you'll see, far more affordable than it would have been if it would actually be from Lego. So, yeah, let's see what we have in this box. By the way, the artwork on the box, as you can see, looks very good, of high quality. So that's nice, and the kit contains just over 450 pieces. It is rated at ages 9 and up. I think that's a little conservative, by the way. And you can apparently build two models from this kit. Does the box... You've got, a sporty track-based car, as you can see. And more of an, maybe an agricultural... Yeah, I'm not sure what to call this. A truck. And what do they call this? Well... Yeah, so I'll be building both, why not? So let's first see what we have in this box here. All right, we've got ourselves a manual. We'll have a closer look at the manual build instructions in a minute. And besides that, bags with parts and everything you need to be able to drive this car is in the box, minus some AA batteries. Yeah, three AA batteries to run this kit. If you just want to use it as a static shelf queen, you obviously don't need batteries, but if you want to run it, three batteries and you should be good to go. Okay, parts bags. The bags themselves are not labeled, but yeah, it's not a huge kit. You can easily see what's in the bags. Okay, this looks just fine. As I mentioned before, the parts are interchangeable with genuine Lego bricks, so that's nice. Maybe you have a collection of Lego kits, so you can use these parts with your other Lego parts. Okay, let's have a look at the build instructions to see if that's any good. What do we have here? Oh, a decal sheet, all right. Okay, this actually looks very reminiscent of Lego instruction manuals. As you can see here, they've got a one-to-one scale sample or reference of the parts you need. So if you are not completely sure if you selected the correct part, you can just put the part on the manual over here and you can check if you've got the right one. And that's done throughout the manual, and it's in full color, as you can see. It's looks very clear to me. And I'm actually not completely sure if the manual covers both models. It actually looks like it doesn't. No, the manual only covers this model, the, well, buggy style tracked vehicle. I'll have a look online if I can locate the build instructions for the other vehicle, that more agricultural truck kind of a vehicle. If I do locate it, I'll have a link to that in the description down below as well. Okie dokie, I'll do a separate video where there are time lapse of the builds. That would probably be two separate videos with my builds. Right now in this video, I'll cut straight to the finished car. Here we go. And there is the finished car. Well, almost finished. I haven't applied all decals yet. I've only applied the decals on this flag. I wanted to show you what it looks like without the decals. If you can get away without applying the decals. Some people don't like to apply decals on their bricks. And I can get into that. I mean, these pieces you might want to use for other projects in the future. So I think you can definitely get away without applying decals. It looks great. I'm actually impressed. It's even if it wasn't a running car, it's nice as a shelf queen, right? Quite a striking car. Now, one thing, I think the spoiler does look a little plain without a decal. Tell me what you think, but yeah, a black slab. You can, by the way, adjust its angle. Not that it does anything, of course. But yeah, again, this looks a little plain to me without the decal. So let's put that on. Doesn't that look a lot better with this, just one decal? It breaks up that black slab of a spoiler a bit. Looks a lot better in my humble opinion, of course. And yes, the other decals, I will apply them in a second. But again, I think the car looks great without them. So yeah, let's cut to the car with decals. Okay, fair enough. It does add to the car, the decals. It looks a little more sophisticated. More like a real off-road tracked car. So yeah, I could have done without the stickers, decals, but it does look very, very nice. Tell me what you think, of course. And that's all well and good. Does it drive well as well, though? Let's find out. Here we go. Okay, so I've created a bit of an artificial landscape here on my bed to see if the... Okay, steep inclines? No, not so much. Apparently it doesn't have a lot of grip on my bed either. Well, actually, not that bad. Yeah, okay, so steep inclines, no, that doesn't work at all. I'll show you a little clip in a second on with the car driving on carpet. That does work very well. Oh, by the way, it does take a little getting used to the controls as well, as it drives like a tank, this car, right? And yeah, so let's cut to some driving on carpet. And as you can see, it has tons of grip on the carpet. It's not like I showed you a second ago. It's not an off-road vehicle. It won't take enormous climbs, but the grip is certainly there, as you can see. So that works out very well, I think. Now, on wooden or maybe stone floors, here's a little clip of that. Yeah, the then tracks They are plastic, right? There's no rubber on the tracks, so it doesn't have a lot of grip, or hardly any grip on a wooden floor, as you can see here. It is fun, by the way. It's a kind of a drift car almost on a wooden floor, so that's fun. So yeah, it sure is fun to drive. Apart from being a nice static display model, it is, especially for kids, this is a lot of fun. So yeah, that works out pretty well. So guys, what is my take on this low-cost brick-based toy, remote control toy? Do you get your money's worth? Should you order one? And to answer the first thing, well, you've seen the price. Well, check out the link in the description down below. It is incredibly affordable, this RC, a brick-based RC. It's fun to build. The build was super duper easy. No guesswork. The construction went together perfectly. Yeah, so in terms of value for money, it's unbeatable. It's incredible, actually. You get a lot of toy for very little money. So in that sense, sure, very nice thing to get for you or for your kids. Okay, so there's one elephant in the room here. Of course, you could argue that it's a Lego ripoff. Yay! So yeah, if you feel that this is a Lego ripoff, maybe you shouldn't order one, right? You should just stick to Lego, and that's completely fine. I've had a lot of Lego in my younger years, and I'm a fan of the brand. So again, you might argue that this is a Lego ripoff. If you have no problem with that, go and order one. I should add to that that Lego itself didn't invent the brick-based system. Actually, you could argue that they stole the idea themselves. But that's a discussion for another video, maybe. Again, it's up to you. I think it's value for money. But if it being too much like Lego robs you the wrong way, then it's probably not for you. So that's it. That's my take. Tell me what you think, of course. Is it a Lego ripoff? Is it just fine? And hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, thumbs up, of course. And if you didn't like it, thumbs down. Thank you very much either way. And catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.